Welcome to SRA 221. In this video, we will be discussing mandatory access control. In military and other high security computer systems, a policy of mandatory access controls is used. The goal in these systems is to restrict the dissemination of information. Objects in these systems, such as files, are assigned security labels that restrict who is allowed to access them. A label contains the required clearance level, which often ranges from classified to unclassified, secret, top secret, and so forth. Users of the system are assigned clearance levels. The key is the label attached to each subject and object shown in this slide. A subject is assigned a security level, as we discussed in the previous slide. In mandatory access control, two rules then apply. When the user tries to access an object, the security level of the user and level of the object are compared. The user is given access to the requested object only if he or she satisfies no read up and no write down rules. The no read up rule states that a user cannot read an object that is above classification than its own classification. So, a user with secret clearance cannot access a file that is marked as top secret. The other rule that is not as intuitive is the no write down rule, which means a user of a given classification cannot write to lower classifications on objects. Note that however the subject may actually read that file, but the user is not allowed to rewrite on the file. Formally, mandatory access control is demonstrated utilizing the Bell-LaPadula BLP model. According to official ISC 2 guide to the CISSP exam, and I quote, "The Bell-LaPadula model, BLP, is a state mandatory access control model used for enforcing access control in government and military applications. The model is a formal state transition model of computer security policy that describes a set of access control rules which use security labels on objects and clearances for subjects. Security labels range from the most sensitive, e.g. top secret, down to the least sensitive, e.g. unclassified or public. The transfer of information from a high sensitivity document to a lower sensitivity document may happen in the Bell-LaPadula model via the concept of trusted subjects. Trusted subjects are not restricted by the property. Trusted subjects must be shown to be trustworthy with regard to the security policy. With Bell-LaPadula, users can create content only at or above their own security level, i.e. secret researchers can create secret or top secret files, but may not create public files. No write down. Conversely, users can view content only at or below their own security level, i.e. secret researchers can view public or secret files, but may not view top secret files. No read up. The strong star property is an alternative to the star property, in which subjects may write to objects with only a matching security level. Thus, the write up operation permitted in the usual star property is not present, only a write to same operation. The strong star property is usually discussed in the context of multi-level database management systems and is motivated by integrity concerns. Now let's take a quick look at contrasting discretionary access control and mandatory access control. In previous lectures, we discussed discretionary access control. According to Trusted Computer System Evaluation Criteria, United States Department of Defense, and I quote, "In computer security, discretionary access control is a type of access control defined by the Trusted Computer System Evaluation Criteria as a means of restricting access to objects based on the identity of subjects and/or groups to which they belong." Mandatory access control, on the other hand, refers to a type of access control by which the operating system restricts the access of subjects to objects on the basis of security labels, as we previously discussed. This method only allows a subject to access an object only when certain constraints are satisfied.